Hi folks, this is Checkpoint Quiz 11.4. We're given 2 points in rectangular coordinates and we're asked to convert them to polar coordinates. And so the equations we do this, since we're given x and y, we need to find r and theta. And so we know that r squared is x squared plus y squared, and the tangent of theta is y over x. That's assuming x isn't 0. If x is 0, then theta is either pi over 2 or 3 pi over 2 or some coterminal angle to that. Okay, so let's start off in part A. The first thing I always do is plot the point so I have an idea what quadrant it's in. That'll help me find theta later. And so it's 2 radical 3 comma negative 2. So it's going to be down here in quadrant 4. Alright, so I go in, r squared is x squared plus y squared. And when I square the 2, I get 4. When I square radical 3, I get 3. 4 times 3 is 12. When I square negative 2, I get 4. So I get r squared is 16. That means r is plus or minus 4. And even though we're not asked to do so, we'll do one with a positive radius and one with a negative radius. Okay, so let's say r equals 4. Well, let's go look at theta now. Tangent of theta is y over x, so that's negative 2 over 2 radical 3, which is negative 1 over radical 3. And if I'm taking a positive r value, so if I take r equals positive 4, then that means I'm going to start at the pole. I'm going to go out 4 units and then rotate around to get to that point. I'm going to rotate counterclockwise. And so the question is, what angle is this? So if I look at this, the tangent of theta is negative 1 over radical 3. We've got a reference angle of pi over 6. This is 11 pi over 6. So with r equal 4, I can take theta to be 11 pi over 6. All right, now I could take r to be less than 0. So I could pick r to be negative 4. If I'm picking negative 4, then that means I'm going to start rotating from the negative x-axis. And then rotate around, in which case I'd be rotating an angle of 5 pi over 6. So one representation with a positive r value is 4, 11 pi over 6. One representation with a negative r value is 4, 5 pi over 6. So how can I check these? I can check it using the formulas x equals r cosine theta, y equals r sine theta. And so if I look at the 4 comma 11 pi over 6, x is 4 cosine 11 pi over 6. And the cosine of 11 pi over 6 is radical 3 over 2. So I get 2 radical 3, which is what I'm supposed to get for the x. And the y is 4 sine 11 pi over 6, which is 4 times negative 1 half, which is negative 2, which is the y coordinate I'm supposed to get. And I'll leave it to you, if you choose negative 4, 5 pi over 6, we get the correct x and y as well. So that'll do it for part A. Okay, in part B, we've got the point 1, 3. And so once again, I always do a quick sketch to determine the quadrant it's in. And this is going to be in quadrant 1. So I go to my equations. I know r squared is x squared plus y squared. So in this case, I get r squared is 1 squared plus 3 squared. So I get r squared is 10, which gives me two choices. R is plus or minus radical 10. Now, as far as theta is concerned, I know the tangent of theta is y over x. So in this case, the tangent of theta is 3 over 1, which is 3. And that's not one of the common tangent values we know. That means in order to find theta, we got to use the inverse trig functions. So if I look at my picture here, if I start with a positive r value, then I'm going to head out this way and then rotate counterclockwise. So that means that for positive r, positive square root 10, I can pick theta to be the arctangent of 3. If I want to choose a negative r value, or so this rather gives me the point radical 10, arctangent 3. If I want to pick the negative r value, then that would be r is negative radical 10. Then I have to rotate from the negative x-axis. So I'd have to go out this way, and I could rotate pi, then an extra arctangent 3. And so this will give me negative square root 10 pi plus arctangent 3. Right? And we want to check our answers. Okay, so to check our answers, I use x is r cosine theta and y is r sine theta. And so let's check the radical 10 arctangent 3. So x is radical 10 cosine arctangent 3. And y is radical 10 sine arctangent 3. So we need to go back and think about section 10.6 with the inverse trig functions. If I let theta, right, theta is the arctangent of 3, then what do I know about theta? I know that the tangent of theta is 3, and theta is in quadrant 1. It's an acute angle. So I go back to my identities. 1 plus tangent squared theta is secant squared theta. So secant squared theta is tangent squared theta plus 1. Tangent squared is 9 plus 1 is 10. So I get the secant of theta is plus or minus the square root of 10. But since theta is in quadrant 1, I'm going to pick the positive square root. So I get that. And if secant theta is radical 10, that means cosine theta is 1 over radical 10. And now that I know tangent and cosine, I know what sine is. Sine of theta is tangent times cosine. So it's 3 times 1 over radical 10, or 3 over radical 10. So now I can put this in. X is radical 10 cosine arctangent 3. That's radical 10 times 1 over radical 10, which is 1, which is what it's supposed to be. And radical 10 sine of arctangent 3, that's radical 10 times 3 over radical 10, which is 3, And that's exactly what he's supposed to be. Now, I'll leave it to you to check the other answer we had with the pi plus arctangent 3. You can either just use geometry or you can use a sum and difference identity to check that it works out in that case as well. So that'll do it for number 1.